Whoa, wow. Hey guys, it's Layla. Welcome back to the channel. And I'm hitting you guys up with an assumptions video. I haven't done like a fun, taggy type video in like maybe a year and a bit, maybe. I asked you guys over on my Instagram, if you're not following me, make sure you do that, what assumptions you had of me. And before I jump into that, two things. Number one, you guys really think so highly of me, so I super appreciate that. I really thought I was gonna go into those assumptions and be like, whoa, wow. But all of them was just so positive and so nice, and I was just like, oh, wow. Thanks, guys. If you do follow me on Instagram, you know that at the end of last year, I announced that I am officially a NCS partner for 2020, which I'm super excited about. If you don't know what NCS is, for young people who kind of, straight up outside of GCSE, is an opportunity to come together to tap into your potential, to kind of trial out your ideas, and most importantly, to make connections that you will take with you for the rest of your life. If you are in England and Northern Ireland, definitely sign up to NCS. You do not want to miss this summer. I will leave the details below. NCS's theme for the year is Know We Can, which is all about subverting the no's that you get throughout life as a young person. And actually, even as you get older, people still tell me no, and it's taking those no's and subverting them. Okay, guys, so let's jump into these assumptions. And I collated them here on my iPad, okay? I assume you are an independent thinker and you don't accept statements without proof. Yeah, definitely that's literally me. So that's a very good assumption. That's a correct assumption, actually. It's a true assumption. And I am literally Madam Google. Like, I Google everything. If I hear something, like a word I've never heard before, or if I'm presented with, new information, I always do my due diligence. I will always kind of look to get kind of, a better understanding all the time. And that's why when I do make my videos, especially like my hair care related videos, wherever possible, I literally come to you guys with like that scientific kind of, backing. I believe that every day is a new opportunity to learn something new. So I always make room to learn. I'm very teachable as a person in all aspects of my life. And have I always been that way? I think I've always been that way. I've always been that way. I think it's just the way that I was raised. I was made to read a lot of books, and it's just made me naturally curious as a person. But it also makes me kind of want to know the real deal, like all the time. So yes, thanks. You're very successful. And thank you. I mean, thanks. Success is very subjective. Everybody defines success to them differently. I definitely don't have like £1 million in my account, but from where I was yesterday to where I am today, I would definitely say that I am successful in my own right. And it's quite funny because, I'm a content creator, number one, and then also I am now an entrepreneur on top of that. And actually, this is something that I wouldn't have achieved because growing up as an African, as you guys know, the kind of creative route isn't necessarily like the one that is championed. So it was something that I had to push past. I had to push past, the opinions of like family in order to really pursue this. And I remember when I first started YouTube, I didn't even tell my mom. Like, I used to, upload my videos from uni and never told her. And I remember the summer that I did come home and I did mention it to her, and she was like, why would you do that? Like, why would you put yourself out there like that, And now she's literally like my number one supporter. Very confident girl, you always have a plan, always know what you're doing, very kind-hearted. I mean, guys, honestly, so I'm telling you guys think so highly of me. I literally did not get like one ratchet assumption or anything like that, and I was really surprised. Yes, I embrace that fully. I am definitely a confident young woman, And actually, it hasn't always been the case. Like, I haven't always been this confident in who I am or this confident in what I want to achieve. But I definitely feel like that's come along with growth. That's come along with almost being defiant. There are loads of things that I wanted to achieve in life that I had to be defiant, in order to make those happen. So sometimes defiance is something that helps you to grow as a person. It helps you to learn and it helps you to evolve. And I had to take a few no's and turn them into my own personal yes I cans, basically. Yeah. You're open but very guarded. You don't share easily. People have to be really close, and that is 100% facts. Okay, like that is a big fat F. That's a fact. I am quite guarded, and I don't keep a lot. I don't keep like a lot of close friends. I don't keep a lot of close friends. Literally, could count my close friends on like one hand with maybe like a couple of fingers spare. And that's just because I've been taught growing up that, everything's not for everybody. I can't be sharing everything with everyone. And then also, the mind of others is where dreams go to die sometimes. So, you might share something with somebody, and that person can literally sit on that dream with whether it's like their response to you, whether it's the way they behave. People without realizing it can become dream killers in your life. So I'm very, very cautious about that. Yes, and you do have to be very close to me. I was just checking. You do have to be very close to me. But then, like I said, there aren't a lot of people that are very, very close to me. I don't do that. I don't do that. So, yeah. I assume you are very focused, organized, and hardworking. You're very detail oriented. Once again, I mean, thanks guys. It's like compliment galore. I feel like when I went into Instagram to view these assumptions, it was like a place I went for my ego to be like stroked very lovingly. So thank you guys very much. I like to think I am very focused. I like to think I'm very driven in life. There's things that I want to achieve and like I will just work on that thing. So we all know how the saying goes. If you fail to plan, then you fail. You what? Huh? If you fail to plan, then you plan to fail. So keep that in mind always, and always have like a clear vision of what your goals are. And then more importantly, like you have to do a map. For me, a goal, when I set a goal, it's a destination. But actually, the most important part of setting that goal is the journey to get to that goal and planning that journey. And it's on that journey, on that path, that you really learn all your life lessons, where you have your L's, but then you learn how to, to turn those L's into like good stuff. So I'm gonna end it right there because I think my video is getting a little bit long, and I love to twerk. But actually, I think that was a really good assumption to end on in terms of being a planner and things like that. So definitely, if you are kind of just coming out of your GCSEs, do sign up to NCS. It's a great way for you to plan, to kind of get into planning, like what you want your future to look like, what you want your next few years to look like. If you fail to plan, you plan to fail. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If there's any other like fun tags that you'd love me to do, please leave a comment below. Let me know. If you're not subscribed, be sure to do so. If you enjoyed this video, my little tidbits on life, okay? I'm sorry it wasn't really like ratchet and scandalous. Unfortunately, you guys don't think I am any of those things. Or fortunately, you guys don't think I am any of those things, so I'm thankful for that actually. So yeah, do let me know if there's any tags. Do subscribe, do like the video. I will catch you guys in the next video. Tally ho, love you guys.